Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Adults. As the first custom video of the year and continue with the custom series of Persona 5, this time is the turn of Haru Okumura, aka Beauty Thief, Noir. The A member to join to the Phantom Tits, and just like Makoto, the senpai of the group. It is also worth to mention that her thief name refers to the word black in French. In personal words, I felt that Haru's design is a bit more complex and elaborated than the design of her friends. I mean, look at that hair! I also mentioned that her color palette is one of the most amazing and charming. And as in all my videos, on my Instagram I share the concept art I made to study the details of the character a little better. So, without further ado, let's get started! For the base doll, I will use an Ever After High Blondie Lots that I had stored from last year. And now, I just noticed that she has a stitch mark in her eye, as if a large needle has been stuck in her. No! Well, I will solve it later. First, I'm gonna remove all her hair to be able to work on Haru's hair. Now with the head clean, I will pass paint around it so I can get the shape of the wig cap. For her hair, I will use this ball yarn that I bought on Amazon since the fiber seemed perfect to me due to how thick it is, and also because of its softness. And I also bought it for the color tone, since I felt Haru's hair varies from different colors, sometimes with orange tones and pink tones, and yeah, that was very confusing. But in the end, I opted for this lime brown color that seemed more appropriate. And more so when it comes to make her curls. Which by the way, I took my time and I did a lot as you can see. And with the curls done, it's time to glue them from the bottom up all over her wig cap. Wow, I'm not done yet and already looks quite fluffy. Okay, I decided that I'm going to do another technique so that the middle line on her hair comes out more natural. One that I learned in Moonlight Jewel's channel. I take my scissors and I cut half of the hair. Then I pass a few strokes of glue inside. Then I will glue a web of hair that then I will flip it. Stay in this way, and I repeat it on the other side, looking Haru's hair like this. It's just a matter of passing a scissor and we will have the shape of her hair finished. To protect everything and that those curls don't lose their shape, I will fix it up a little with glue and water, and then fix the curls with hairspray. Staying this way, it looks so fluffy! With her hair ready, I'm gonna use a measure tape to take the measurements to get the pattern of her musketeer hat, which I will transfer to a foamy foil that I will cut. With the pieces cut, I will join them with hot glue and make the shape I want. and I will glue a wire around the shade so that it can be easily bent. Now I continue joining the pieces and I secure them with more hot glue. Giving me this shape as you can see. Yeah, it looks a bit of cowboy style at the moment. But the good thing is that at least fits perfectly on the doll's head. Off camera, I covered the entire hat with black fabric and then I passed in 3 layers of glue to give me this result. Now I will paint everything in dark purple, resemble the color that the original has. And then I will glue a thick magenta ribbon around with the help of my silicone glue. Okay, for the feathers of the hat, I decided to make them from scratch, since if I use artificial ones, they will be damaged over time. The first thing is to make the skeleton with a fine wire as you can see in this shot. And I will make the feathers like macrame, passing one strip of yarn to the other surrounding the wire in this way. Now I repeat the same thing over and over again. Giving me this result for the feather with the same technique to make hair wet. Then I made a cut and I made the shape I want, remaining in this way and fixed it with glue. It's just a matter of gluing the feathers to the head and it's done. And looking like this on the doll's head. For her mask, which Haru uses to call her persona Melody, I will do it in the same way I did Queen's corset, wrapping her entire head with fabric and making tie, and then putting 3 layers of white glue on it. Once dry, I drew the shape of her mask using the doll's eyes as a guide, in order to remove the fabric from her head. Okay, I had to admit, this is the weird way I have made a mask. I have no words. And now I will cut the excess part with scissors. Staying this way. And then finish it painting all with black paint. Looking like this, the idea is that she doesn't need elastic to hold her face as the hell helps with that. And with that done, it's time to make her Phantom Thief outfit. I already had the pattern mark on this pale pink fabric. Now I begin to join the pieces with a needle and thread. Here, I will make some cuts that I will later sew on the fabric. Staying this way. Now, I continue sewing. Thank you. With the piece of the blues almost ready, I will try it on the body of the doll. It looks good, but it will look better with everything is joined with threads. And this is how the blues looks, as you can see. I dye it with more paint that the color could be appreciated a little more and putting some gnats on it. And off camera, I made her puffy pants. Now I'm gonna make her black corset with these pieces you see here. Thus leaving the piece of Noir's corset. For the bottom part, I will use this elastic fabric to make the pantyhose that she wears on her outfit. And I will sew them directly on her legs to get the shape. It was a bit complex to work with this type of fabric since it felt very delicate. But in the end, they could be sewing without any problem, giving me the result I wanted. I decided in the end to remove the snaps from the blues and sew it directly to the body as with her pants. And the same for the corset as well. Now with 3D paint, I will make the bottoms of her corset, which will later paint it with gold paint. Off camera, I took the liberty to make her neck jabot, the same one that I will glue directly to her blouse with my silicone glue. For the shoes, I will use this from Apoxie that I will modify with the help of my scalpel, cutting the parts I don't need. Yes, the cuts don't look good, but don't worry, in the end I will fix everything with the help of my epoxy sculpt, making the shape I wanted. So I can paint them with black paint. And ending with them putting some final decorations with fabric. And we have her shoes ready. To finish, I use a black ribbon that goes around her waist to make her belt. That's all done. Off camera, I made her grenades that surround one side of the bell with epoxy. And wow, the result is incredible. Okay, now with the outfit finished, let's move on to her face. Oh, but before going to the repaint, I bought these precision brushes that I got from Amazon. They're special for working with liner dents, or in my case, doll faces. And they really feel very comfortable with the touch. I really want to try them on Haru's face, and in my next videos. Well, going back to the repaint, with pure acetone I begin to erase the factory paint from the doll. And then see myself face to face with this dolor in the neck. So that the stitch mark was not notable on the face, I decided as always to mark the baseline of the face with a light watercolor pencil. And made the lash line help me to cover up. By recreating Haru's face, I also want to highlight her big forehead, just like she has in the game. And I concluded that I could achieve that effect by how I draw her eyebrows. And well, with my baselines done, I will continue to fill Haru's face with more colors, starting with the eyes and giving some highlights with the white pencil. To later give touches of blush to the lids and on her cheeks, trying to make the makeup look natural. Now with a black pencil, I begin to outline Haru's eyelashes more as well, giving details in other parts. and with a brown pencil, I fill her pupil with color. Now with the same white pencil that I used on her eyes, I will give her more illumination. With that ready, now I can use my new brushes on her face. Finish it everything by putting the shine on her eyes and protecting the work with Ultraglass varnish. And that's how Haru's face looks like, and to be honest, looks better than I expected, and without any sign of the stitch mark. Let's see now how she looks with her hair on. Luce tan hermosa, wow! To finish with the doll, I paint her hands with a lavender paint so that it resembles the color of her gloves. And on camera, I made the respective battle weapons, which will be her axe and her grenade launcher, which, by the way, were too fun to do, especially her axe. And with all that, Noir is ready. I'm definitely very happy to have achieved a result like this, and especially because how her hairstyle turned out. Seriously, I'm so happy. Thanks for watching this video. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. You can also follow me on Instagram to see previews of upcoming videos. And our next and almost last phantom tip to come is Crow. My name is Eric, and I will see you next time. Bye!